Every once in a while I get a really great deal at the thrift store, and this is one of those times. When this was sitting on the shelf, the first thing I saw was this sticker on the front, and then I sort of realized what it was, and I was like, no, it can't be one of those, and sure enough, yes it is. It's a Digital8 Video Walkman, and yes, that is the price I paid. I opened it up and everything looked intact. I didn't have any way to test it in the store, but for this price, I pretty much grabbed it and paid and ran out of the store. So these things sell for a pretty penny on eBay, even when they're broken. And as you'll see in a little bit, this one is actually working perfectly fine. So this is the GV-D800 Digital8 Video Walkman. It's basically a camcorder without the camera section, so you just get the recording and playback functions. And you get a built-in LCD screen. It's a 4-inch screen, as it says on the front there, with stereo speakers built in. And you get all your controls for playing and recording video. It says it can record or play Digital8 video, and it can play analog Video8 and Hi8 video. On the side are all the inputs and outputs. We have a headphone jack, an AV input, the same kind of connector that they used on their camcorders, S-video input, S-video output, composite video output, a power output for using an RF modulator, the same kind that was used with their camcorders, and your left and right stereo audio outputs, and an LANC remote control jack. This also supports wireless remote controls. You can see the sensor on the front right there. So the same kind of remotes that you use with a Handycam work with this. On this side, you see this cover over here. That is the connector for the optional TV tuner module. But that would have been only an analog TV tuner, so it's not too useful these days. On the back, we get loops for a shoulder strap. You get your DC power input. There's the slot for putting an L-size info-lithium battery, like one of these. So you can run this thing on batteries. And also the DV jack for connecting to the firewire port of a computer or another camcorder or even a DVD recorder. Some of those have a DV input on them. So you could dub directly from this to a DVD recorder. And this is an IR emitter for controlling a VCR. In case you're dubbing from this to a VCR, this can actually send the command to the VCR to start the recording and stop it, so it can do it automatically. On the bottom there is the information. This one was made in 2001, and there's a little reset button down there. There, I peeled off the sticker so you can see the Video Walkman logo. And it has engraved into the front here MHS and Roundup. That was probably Montgomery High School here in New Jersey, which was the original owner of this thing. And they evidently kept it in very good condition. So now, with that battery attached, we can turn it on. It says clock set. I don't know if this has a backup battery in it somewhere. I haven't seen any obvious little door of where one would go, so I don't know. You can see the display is working. And you can go through the menus, which are pretty much the same as on a Handycam, except there are a couple more features, such as the video editing feature. Since this can do some pretty advanced video editing, back in the day before people did it on their computers. And we can eject tape compartment. And that slides open, and I have a Digital8 tape ready to go here. So we can just put that in, close the door. You can see it load into the compartment there. And now it's telling me to eject the tape, so I don't know what's going on. It was working perfectly before, but it may be having some trouble now. Okay, it was acting a little erratically for a while there, but I think I got it working now. I put in another tape, and let's see if this works. This is an analog tape, so it should automatically switch to video 8 or high 8 mode. Yep, there it goes. And it's playing. Oh, it was. Alright, let's see what happened here. I've ejected the tape fine. Let's see, is that roller in the right position? You see that little roller there? The black one right next to the white one? Those can pop off and cause trouble. So I'm just pushing down on it. So let's see if that helped or if it's still going to complain. No, it's still complaining. Okay, I got it to start fast forwarding, so that's progress. Maybe I just need to exercise the tape motor a little bit, since I don't know how many years it's been since this thing was used. So I'll let it fast forward all the way, and I'll try to rewind all the way and see if I can get it to at least do that. And while it's going, I should mention this thing has super laser link. So if you have a laser link receiver on your TV, you can send video from this thing to the TV wirelessly. I have a video about the laser link system, if you haven't seen it. So it's the same feature that Sony had on their camcorders around this time. Okay, it fast forwarded and rewinded the tape all the way without complaining. So let's see if it'll play now. If I can hit the button, there we go. Seems to be working. So I'm gonna turn the volume down and let this thing play all the way through the tape just to give it a bit of a workout, and I'll see what happens. And I should mention, if you find one of these and you can't get the tape mechanism to work at all, you can still use one of these video Walkmans to convert analog video sources to digital, because it does real-time video capture. All you need to do is plug in a video source into these inputs here, such as from a VCR or an old camcorder, and then plug the DV output into your computer's FireWire input, and it'll stream it directly without even needing to use the tape mechanism. So that's a very useful feature of this model. It's been playing for an hour and a half so far with no problems. This part of the tape was recorded in LP speed, and it's playing fine, which is a good sign that the playback head on this thing is in good shape, because LP recordings are very sensitive to the alignment and the condition of the playback head. If it's not perfect, you'll get noise in the video. Well, this one looks just fine. Now I put it in a Digital 8 tape, and it's also playing fine. So I think it just needed a bit of a workout to get everything working properly. Because now we can play and fast forward and rewind. The only thing that concerns me a little bit is how abruptly it ejects. I didn't think it would be like that, but maybe it was, I don't know. I didn't think it would just slam open like that, but maybe that's how they designed it. And I can also use this thing to watch movies. Got these on eBay a while back. They're Video 8 movies. Still sealed in the original shrink wrap. For a time in the late 80s and early 90s, this one is 1991, they were releasing movies on Video 8 tape. So let's play one of these. And there's what a pre-recorded Video 8 tape looks like. They put the label over where the Write Protect tab would go, so you cannot record over one of these tapes. It says duplicated in digital stereo, so I wonder if this thing will play in stereo. Okay, here we go. Switching to analog mode. Of course, there's going to be a whole bunch of FBI warnings and previews and whatever before the movie actually starts. So I'll just fast forward it a bit. Sneak preview
of movies coming to a theater near you.
You got any new hot books, Spider?
I just got these in yesterday. Look at this.
They're based on what I like to call the facts of life.
Candy and Durwood go camping.
Sounds educational.
In Jack Twiller's imagination, he's a legend in his own time.
My tent won't stay up, Jack.
Unfortunately, it stopped right there.
Okay, I don't want to play too much of that because probably even the previews have copyright matches on them. So it looks like that tape is working. I just listened with headphones and the tape is in stereo, so I'll give you a little sample of that. So the Video Walkman seems to be working fine now, and I didn't even have to repair anything. I just had to use it a little bit.